Movie fans might remember the 2013 film American Hustle, starring Bradley Cooper, Jennifer Lawrence, Christian Bale, and Amy Adams. Also featured this 1978 Eldorado, which could be yours.
When this car was used in American Hustle, they were showing opulence. And that's why they picked this particular car, because this was the image of success in 1978.
For seller Mark Epstein, this is what success looks like. A rotating car collection that is his passion, or perhaps his obsession.
Well, it depends if you're asking my wife or me.
Over the years, his cars have turned quite a few heads, including some in Hollywood.
What was your first movie car?
I think it was The Box with Cameron Diaz. We just did Equalizer 2.
When you see your car on the big screen, are you a proud papa?
Oh, yeah.
Although most of his cars are camera ready.
This is my favorite right here. That is great.
The one best suited for the big screen may be his most humble.
This is a 1989 Oldsmobile Cutlass Sierra.
Okay. And what makes this special?
Because it's not special is what makes it special. If you're just trying to set the tone for the background and having cars drive by, this is something that you want. But the car collectors don't really collect them because they're very uninteresting to us.
But the movie people love it.
Now, out of the background and into the front seat of our American Hustle car.
All right, so I'm gonna play the role of Amy Adams today. You can be Christian Bale. And this ride is pretty dynamite, I will say. It is cozy. They don't make cars like this anymore.
No, they definitely don't. It's like being in the living room.
So if you get the call that somebody wants to buy this car, you're gonna be sad?
Oh yeah, I'm always sad. And then excited about the next one. Always on the hunt.
So if you're in the market for a beautiful, big, blue piece of film history, what's the price tag?
This one's only $7,000.
Not a bad deal, considering that more high-profile movie cars like the original Batmobile sold for over $4 million. If you're not the Hollywood type, then perhaps you'd enjoy a scenic train ride to New Hampshire's Mount Washington Valley. In addition to great skiing and these jaw-dropping views, you'll find for sale a very different kind of car.
It's really a caboose that was built in about 1926 and was run by the Chesapeake and Ohio Railroad. A lot of these cabooses have been retired here and have been converted to very small, very efficient living situations.
The man tasked with moving this train car is Badger Realty's David Cianciolo. He's an expert. After all, this isn't his first caboose.
Most buyers are looking for something unusual, funky, and fun to own, and inexpensive to maintain and operate and live there.
How inexpensive?
For this particular one we're discussing, the asking price is $44,000.
With a price like that, it's no wonder that Cianciolo has interest. Even during our interview, a passing family stopped to take a look. We think the little guy is sold, but we're able to hold him off long enough to get a look inside.
Every square inch of space is utilized for a purpose. Some of the interesting aspects showing the vintage period of the 1920s era is the beaded Victorian pine, which was very popular siding within nicer homes at that time. Stained glass was very popular in the Victorian period, but that is a new door, and they've created a new stained glass window. Because oftentimes they would have, due to rocking of the rail car, they would get cracked.
Another striking feature of the caboose is this cupola, where workers once sat on 24-hour watch for trouble.
It could have been a little bit of Wild Buffalo Bill, perhaps, but I think animals had a lot to do with it.
You can still see animals from this train car turned tiny home, and although it won't take you around the world, relax and enjoy the view.